told you it was all meant to be. Would you believe me? Would you love me? It's almost that feeling we may be fooling. So tell me that you don't think I'm crazy when I tell you love has come here and now. A moment like this, some people wait a lifetime. For a moment like this, some people search forever for that one special kiss. Oh, I can't believe it's happening to me. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like this.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same thing. But you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take, but more than you.
you look back on times we had, I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star, and we came so far, and no, they won't forget. Yeah. Whenever you remember, time's gone by. Remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us.
I'd like to take a moment to introduce the faculty, staff, and our speaker at this time. To my left is Cheryl Lurbinger, followed by Michelle Fry, Dr. Todd Martin, and Dr. Jeffrey Lashley. To my right is Stephanie Keller, Shelley Doherty, Carissa Atkins, and Don Schmidt. And also not seated on the stage is Robin Cables, Mark Chambers, Karen Christie, Brandy Lloyd, and Laura Haven.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jeff Lashley. And I serve as the president here of Moberly Area Community College. And on behalf of the faculty and the staff and the trustees of MACC, it's my pleasure to welcome you to the first in-person pinning ceremony we've had since the onset of COVID in March of last year. And we are really happy to be here with you in person tonight. Pinning ceremonies are one of my favorite events among all the celebrations we have at MACC. Rituals like pinnings, commencement ceremonies allow us to stop and take a measure of a long and at times challenging journey that's now been completed. This year, the journey had some unprecedented twists and turns and challenges. Our students graduating tonight had to adjust in the middle of the semester to virtual coursework, disrupted schedules, a change to their clinical rotations, and do all that while they also had to adjust their daily lives to the difficulties of pandemic brought to our world. And that's a long list of things we had to adjust to. Completing a nursing program is one of the most challenging curriculums a student can pursue even under the best of circumstances. You all, this class, can be especially proud that each of you have achieved something so impressive and difficult in these unprecedented circumstances. In addition, the faculty in this program had to make the same adjustments on the fly and be sure that the quality and the rigor of the program remained unchanged, while many of the procedures and rules that they adhere to had to change. Their expertise, dedication, and innovation played a big part in the reason that we are here tonight. So I'd like everyone to please join me and ask the faculty and the staff of the program to please stand. And ask everybody here tonight to express our appreciation to them for the hard work they did. I also need to recognize the faculty and the staff that continue to meet the needs of our students in the virtual world. They had to show the same dedication and innovation to keep all the services in place that we have to do to serve our students. So our departments like our financial aid, our student services, our instructional technology, it was truly a team effort throughout the whole college that kept us going through this pandemic. To the students, on your journey in this program, you've made some close friendships that you'll have the rest of your life. And these friends have helped you to get through the rough spots along the way. You studied together, you laughed together, cried together, complained together, eaten together, had fun together. The most important, you supported each other along the way, and now you're finishing together. Outside of your classmates, you got the same kind of support from your families, your parents, your grandparents, your friends, your significant others, your children, and they're seated behind you tonight, and they were equally important in your success. So today we thank them as they celebrate this achievement with you. So on behalf of the graduates and of all of us at MACC, we say thank you to the families and friends with us tonight. We know that you're a huge part of the success of your family members. I'm finishing my 25th year working at MACC. And as I previously mentioned, one thing I know for sure, completing a nursing program is one of the biggest challenges you can undertake in higher education. To the graduates, be sure you enjoy this time and be proud of yourself and what you have accomplished. Know you're at the beginning of a new journey where you will make an important difference in the world in a new way. Wherever there is a need for a nurse, there's nothing better than a well-trained, professional, compassionate nurse, especially if they're from MACC. So congratulations, we're proud of you. You'll always be a part of our program at MACC. You are our students. Tonight you become our graduates. Go and make a difference in the world. You're needed more than ever. Congratulations and thank you.
Good evening. I am pleased to introduce our honored guest. Stephanie Kelleher graduated from Coastal Carolina Community College in 2000 with a practical nursing degree. Stephanie has spent 20 years in the nursing family, working as a licensed practical nurse. She has dedicated many hours to various community, clinic, and acute care settings, such as obstetrics, gynecology, home health, pediatrics, and has spent time as a nurse in the Marine Corps base at Camp Lejeune. In 2004, she moved back to the area and established her career at Women's Health Associates, where she has dedicated 16 years of service. During this time, she obtained a Bachelor of Science in Business. She uses this degree and knowledge of nursing to supervise two local rural clinics for Boone Medical Group. When not working, Stephanie is busy taking on family life with her husband, four children, two dogs, multiple chickens, and one barn cat. She enjoys balancing professional responsibility with travel, camping, and various sporting activities. Please join me in welcoming Stephanie Kelleher.
Good evening. I'd like to say thank you for allowing me to be a part of your ceremony tonight and congratulating you on making it through the nursing program. Not only did you make it through the program, which is difficult in itself, you did so during a pandemic, which had to be even more challenging. I can't imagine what it was like to have limited classroom and clinical availability. I must have made it so much harder. So now the real fun begins. There are so many options to choose from out there when you talk about nursing specialties. You shouldn't have any trouble finding something that you love and that you're passionate about. I've been lucky enough to find that over my career since graduating from nursing school in 2000. I've worked in multiple different specialties and ended up landing right where I started back at OBGYN. I heard that many of you are interested in OB, and I would like to say go for it. The nurses that are in these specialties leave a lasting impression on their patients, and it's something that's truly amazing. As an LPN, I was on the clinical side more than in the hospital, labor and delivery, but these patients are something else. I often joke with patients in the clinic when the physicians had to leave because they had to run to the hospital to deliver a baby. They'd be a little irritated and say, well, how long are they going to be? I'd say probably 15 minutes or so. This would leave the patient shocked. 15 minutes to deliver a baby. And I would always use the same verbiage that, yes, the nurses have been over there doing all the hard work. The docs run over, catch the baby, take a picture, and get all the credit. While we know that all the doctors do have a little bit more involvement than that, it's true that the nurses are the ones that leave the lasting impression on patients. Some personal examples for me would be when my mom was in the ICU. I remember the physicians coming in and out, giving us a big medical diagnosis, but it was the nurse that was at her bedside day and night that explained everything and helped us make the difficult decisions and was there for us, consoling us when we really needed her. Another example would be when my daughter was in the emergency room having a febrile seizure. I remember the doctors working on her, but I more so remember the nurse when I forgot every nursing skill I had and just wanted somebody to help my baby, who grabbed me, gave me a hug, and told me that she was in good hands and she was going to be fine, and she was. The nurses are the people that I remember from my encounters more so than the other staff, and I would hope that the patients I've been able to take care of over the years feel that I've been there for them in the same way. I've also been the worst patient ever. Let's face it, all nurses are. We know too much, and we don't follow our own rules. We tell countless patients to drink more water and eat more green leafy vegetables while we're sucking down our mint to Starbucks and giving the nurse next to us our Chipotle order. We refuse to go to the ER when we're having excruciating pain because we're scared we're going to be sent home with the diagnosis of constipation. And then we have this strange sense of relief when we find out we're being prepped for emergency surgery. All I can say is the same advice that I've given multiple patients over the years is make sure you take care of yourselves because you can't take care of anybody else if you're not healthy. Over the course of my career, I've been able to be there with families when they heard their baby's heartbeat for the first time. I've also been there as they suffered a third trimester loss. I've had to give devastating test results to patients and hung up the phone or closed the exam door, set a silent prayer, and then gone home that night to give my babies a tight squeeze. I've had the opportunity to sit VIP at a Kenny Chesney concert. sponsor so that I could take care of a pediatric patient while his mom was able to attend and enjoy herself. These are just a few examples of some of the adventures that I've had through my nursing career and some of those that are out there for you. I could go on a light morning, but I just want to get your pens and get out of here and celebrate. So I'll stop with just a couple pieces of advice. The best advice I could think to give you would be to ask questions. Don't be scared to ask questions. The only people that I really feel have failed that I've worked with are those that don't. Those that don't look before they leap. They jump to conclusions and just make mistakes. We're all going to make mistakes. We're human. Learn from those mistakes and don't make them again. I've even found that being honest with patients and saying, I'm not sure, but I can find out for you, gains you a lot more respect than giving them a vague answer or the wrong information. And last, but certainly not least, never forget what it's like to be the patient. We've all been on the receiving end of the care, and we know the kind of care that we want to receive. Always strive to give that standard of care for your patients, and you'll be successful. Congratulations.
Excellence Award. This award is given to the student that achieves the highest cumulative grade point average throughout the program. This year, I'm pleased to announce that this award goes to Melissa Welch.
Walter and Sophie, for always being open for cuddles when I needed them most, Lastly, I would like to thank my fellow classmates for being my second family throughout the past 2 years. Without you all, I wouldn't have made it this far. Thank you.
Amanda Carney. Amanda is being pinned by her husband, Brad. To my husband, Brad, I could not have done this journey without you and your support. I wouldn't have been brave enough to start it and strong enough to complete it. To my family and kids, they say it takes a village to raise a child, but it also takes a village to help you complete nursing school. I love you all. Thank you.
Alyssa Dodson. Alyssa is being pinned by her mother, Nurse Rita Dodson. I would like to thank God for allowing me to pass nursing school and for always being there through the ups and downs of my life. I would also like to thank my wonderful, loving, and supportive family. I love you so much, and I am truly blessed to spend every day that I can with you.
Sarissa Dodson. Sarissa is being pinned by her dad, Chris Dodson. I would like to say thank you to God for allowing me this opportunity to pass nursing school and carrying me through each semester. Thank you to my parents and family for supporting me throughout the two hardest years of my life. Lastly, thank you to my boyfriend, Ryan, for his encouragement and support, as well as pushing me to do better. I love you all so much.
Peyton Drake. Peyton is being pinned by her father, Andy Drake. To all of my family, friends, classmates, and teachers that have been a part of my journey, thank you. The late nights, long days, the tears, the obstacles, the breakthroughs, and through all of the good and bad days, you have been the people encouraging me and keeping me afloat. This adventure may be coming to an end, but it is just the beginning of my journey as a nurse. Next step, registered nurse.
Elizabeth Hangamelli is being pinned by her father, Tad Hangamelli. To everyone that walked into my story, walked out, or was always there, I'm standing here today because in some way, you helped me find my way. As nervous as I am to begin this next chapter of my story, knowing that I have an amazing support system with me through everything causes my confidence to grow. The rest is still unwritten, and for this I am thankful. For each of you, I am thankful.
Abby Kuttenkuhler. Abigail is being pinned by her sister, Katie Kuttenkuhler, a 2020 MACC ADN graduate. Thank you to everyone who has supported me through this process. I could never have done this without you. It's been a wonderful journey, and I am so excited to see what's next.
Rochelle Myers. Rochelle is being pinned by her friend and nurse, Tina Arnold. I want to thank God for his grace. Without him, I would not be here today. Thank you to Tina Arnold for giving me an opportunity to rekindle my passion for nursing. Thank you to my parents for helping me with the boys, turning your kitchen into school, and learning Zoom. Xavier, thank you for all your hard work around the house and pitching in when I needed help and being an awesome teenager. Fletcher, Thank you for all the hugs and encouragement. Thank you for giving up fun time with me so I could accomplish my dream of becoming a nurse. Paul, thank you for everything you do for our family. Thank you for pushing me to believe I can accomplish this. Thank you for taking on all of the burdens so that I could focus on becoming a nurse. This means that you can soon retire and be the house husband you've always dreamed about.
Mary Motley. Mary's being pinned by her mother, Terry Motley. I would like to thank my family, my friends, my instructors, and my fellow nursing graduates for sticking with me through this journey. I would not be where I am today without each and every one of you.
Kelsey Nicholson. Kelsey is being pinned by her sister, Ashley Whitley. Ashley, growing up, I have always looked up to you. In doing so, you inspired me to go into the nursing profession. I also want to thank my parents, Kendall and Caleb, for supporting and encouraging me throughout this journey. There have been many tough days along the way, and I wouldn't have made it to this point without you guys.
Christy Sawyer. Christy is being pinned by her aunt, Sharon Abraham. I would like to thank my boyfriend, Tyler, for putting up with my stress-induced moodiness and late-night crying sessions. I want to thank my friends for always being there to give me a stress-free night, even though I would still bring my backpack with me to study. Last but certainly not least, I want to thank my parents for providing literally everything else I needed through these last 2 years, from food and a place to stay to keeping a countdown on your phone of how many days I have left. Thank you for always putting things into perspective. I love you all.
Caitlin Shelby. Caitlin is being pinned by her grandmother, Elizabeth Schroeder. Thank you to my wonderful and supportive parents and friends, my friends from class, and all of the amazing and encouraging instructors. I also want to thank my grandparents for all of their love and support. Thank you so much. Love you guys.
Matthew Shipman. Matt is being pinned by his mother and nurse practitioner, Elizabeth Cruz. Thank you, Mom, for demonstrating excellence in the nursing field, which inspired me to pursue this path. And thank you for the years of support leading up to this moment.
Journey. I couldn't have made it without each and every one of you. Mom, Thank you for molding me into the person I am today and for pushing me to always be my best self. Chase, thank you for being my go-to and support person day in and day out. I love you all.
Stevie is being pinned by her husband, Lauren. Lauren, thank you for everything you have done these past 2 years while I have been in school. There have been days when I had my doubts about if I could do this, but you always believed in me and pushed me to keep going, even when I thought I could not. I seriously could not have done this without you. Also, a huge thank you to JJ and Lindsay for all of your help with Dylan throughout the past 2 years.
Can all my classmates please rise? We're going to do the class pledge, so just follow along. I believe nursing is a dynamic profession involving both the arts and sciences. It is an integral part of the healthcare system. In my practice as a nurse, my goals will include the promotion, maintenance, and restoration of health, with respect for the needs and rights of the individual. I will act to safeguard the evolving ethical, legal, and competent practice of my profession. As a nurse, I will be responsible and accountable for my individual nursing actions and judgment. Today, I commit myself to the holistic practice of nursing with all that I am, all that I know, and all that I can give.
Distance, you can try to grab a picture yourself, and we'll try to do this quickly and then